Creativity is courage. That is the vibe I get from my next guest, Ms. Radhika Hamlai. Welcome to Her Story.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you for opening up your space. Today we are in your space where you create, and I am so excited to get to know you, get to know your art, and how you have evolved from Radhika to Radhika Hamlai, the artist. So please tell us, how did it all begin? Was it, I always tend to think that it starts from the beginning, but I could be wrong. So where did art come into your life?
I guess since I was born, I was really interested in light, colors, shadows, observing things, taking things from nature.
Yes.
Well, when you're younger, you really don't understand that, why do you see these things and why do you feel these things? Mm. Of course, you draw and you sketch. I think your first inspiration is your teacher. The teacher is the first person who sort of comes in and says and teaches you how to write.
Yes.
But before they come to write, they teach you how to draw.
Yeah.
So I guess you're always inspired as a child to draw. And the reason that you draw is to release your emotions on paper, which at that time you never realize, and you just do it out of inquisitiveness in your head.
Yes.
And what you draw is something what you're thinking in your unconscious brain. So I think that's where I think everyone is an artist and thinks like that.
I think we all tend to put our minds into paper somehow, in some sort, some in writing, but you chose art.
Yeah.
So is it something, so if you're saying it's something that was with you since the beginning, is it where you chose to study further your studies, or you went a different path and then art?
The reason, I mean, it was really funny because I wanted to become a teacher to begin with when I was younger. And I wanted to write, and I wanted to do things what the teacher did, and I wanted to teach. As I grew older, the whole thought became fearful. And it's like, no, I can never be a teacher because I'm never going to be as good as a teacher. So teaching is out of question, and I'm not going to be doing teaching.
Mm-hmm.
Being an artist was never in my thought that I would even get into art. I used to always draw and paint, but it was passion, and it's something I enjoyed
like
doing.
Like as a hobby, sort of.
As a hobby. Mm-hmm. I finished my education after grade 12, and I'm like, maybe I should go into being a doctor, which I ended up not doing science.
Okay.
And I'm like, I don't know. So it was always like that little bit thought that I'm not too sure kind of a situation.
Yeah.
But it was something I did art as something I sort of de-stress time.
Mm-hmm.
And I always used to listen to music. And of course, art was, you know, something that always led me to everyday evening. As time went on, I studied doing management, which
okay.
is completely out of my comfort zone. And well, I did enjoy that for a bit of time. And after that, I used to finish my university and go for 2 hours of training with the teacher there in India. And that was really interesting for me because I would finish. So those 2 hours I had to spend with art.
With art. It was a teacher to teach you how to paint, basically.
Yes,
okay.
At that time.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, then I came to Oman, I got married, and life changed for me. I started working in the office, and it was like a 9 to 9 job.
And there was no art.
There was no art at
no
all.
For expressing yourself.
Not at all.
How hard
so
must have been?
It was very tough.
I can imagine, yeah.
Because it was something I never realized, that it was art which sort of put together my emotions or me as a person.
Mm.
And as time went on, you know, I got pregnant with my child, and of course I used to paint, still started painting in 1994 again. And of course it got lesser and lesser and lesser until
with the
19...
increased duties of
yes.
motherhood. And
yeah. Then the moment I was expecting my son, it became like, okay, I think I need to get back to what I love.
Mm-hmm.
And since he was born, I think I'm completely into art, mesmerized by it again, all over again. And I enjoy what I do, really enjoy what I do.
I find it interesting to see that it might have been right there at the beginning, the sign was clear from when you were young, and then you stopped, but you kept going back to it, and you stopped, and you kept going back to it.
Yeah.
So I find we never all know our purpose from the first, you know, start.
Right.
We tend to, it pulls us in some
right.
way, and that's exactly what happened to you. And I think some people struggle to know what am I good at? What makes me comfortable?
Right.
And it's just the course of journey of life. You
right.
find yourself going back to something that
right.
completes you, I guess,
right.
in a
yeah.
sense. So I'm sure there were some challenges in there. And that is part of her story, what I like to highlight. So did you know what kind of artist or you wanted to be? How did you end up being a contemporary artist? Why not something
else? I think the way it started is that when I came here, when I came here and I started becoming or thinking that I want to get into art, mm-hmm. The first thing I did is join the Society of Fine Arts. Mm-hmm. Because my sister-in-law is like, Radhika, if you want to get serious, you got to go somewhere and you need to exhibit something. Even though you may think you are really bad at your work, just go and, you know.
And did you think you were bad at your work?
I was so bad at my work.
Really?
Really, really bad at my work.
Okay.
So I thought, yeah, okay, let me just go and join the Society of Fine Arts. And, you know, one of my friends helped me. And she said, okay, you give a proposal. And they accepted me inside. And my first exhibition happened, I think, in 2001. Mm-hmm. And I presented this really, really small drawing with oil on, made of a little boat from Siddab.
Okay.
So it was really interesting because I took my kid with me and, you know, I took him everywhere and I just went and interacted with the artist there. Obviously, language was a very big barrier for me.
I can imagine, yeah.
Because I didn't speak at all. But of course, Oman is a place that everyone always is happy to help and talk to you.
Yes.
You understand the language, you don't understand the language, doesn't matter at all.
You would find a way to communicate, for sure.
So which was really nice, and I started going to the Society of Fine Arts very regularly.
Okay.
So every day evening there was a time that I would be listening to Arabic music because all the people around were listening to Arabic music, and so I enjoyed listening to them. And of course I made so many friends over a period of time there, and I started painting there in the society and it became like another home.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's what really pushed me getting into art very, very seriously, is going to the society and meeting these artists.
And mingling and finding again as well your voice amongst these.
Yeah.
And was there, I remember upon our conversation you talked about failure.
Yeah.
And that is something I want to highlight. I think if you just recall the story that you had presented something and then they said this is not good enough.
Well, there was a time, you know, there was an exhibition with a charity exhibition.
Okay.
And I was presenting myself with these really abstract works, which I just started doing because I went to study in London for a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And I came back and then I went back to study again. And then I created these works after the experience of learning how to do abstract art,
mm-hmm.
which of course I had no clue before that. I mean, I used to paint, but you know, it changes when you have a teacher advising you. So I'd taken these two works and I'd gone to represent myself as
very
an artist,
proudly,
very,
sure.
very proudly. And once I went there, the person is like, it's really bad.
Oh my God.
And I don't think we can take you this time. Try your luck next year. So I'm like, oh my God, I'm really bad. What am I going to be doing? Should I still be doing what I'm doing? But I used to love painting, so I still did. So I went in again the year after that and they're like, oh, they're pretty good. So I'm going to take these pieces. I'm going to be exhibiting. Of course, I didn't sell them. I still have them with me, funnily, but still it gets me back to the thought that you cannot stop.
Yes.
The moment you enjoy doing what you do, you should just keep trying.
Because there is, better at it with
of
time.
Course.
And I always think it's when a person says it's not good enough, it's their point of view.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean that you're not good enough. It just means, Radhika, you need to try again.
Yeah.
You need to be better.
You just
at
need
this.
To. You just need to work a little bit more to up. You know, to work in a way that people understand what you do and why do you do it.
Yeah.
So that challenge I think I still have. There is still a question mark in my head that why am I doing what I'm doing?
Until today.
Until today. Because it's true, isn't it? It's like you have a connection with your work, yes.
Yes.
You know why you are painting. But you know, it's like the work is all about elimination, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you're adding color, you're eliminating something. You're adding a figure, you're eliminating something. So why are you eliminating things? Why are you trying to always improvise yourself? Because getting better means you remove something somewhere to make it get better.
That's deep, Radhika.
But that's what art is, right?
True.
Because that's what art is.
Therefore,
yeah.
I don't see it the way you see it.
Yeah.
So I find what you're saying very deep and it's really making me think.
Yeah.
And getting into the mindset of what an artist is.
Yeah.
So I find that very interesting.
Yeah. Because it's very easy to paint what you see.
True.
Because it's technically is what you need to learn. The technicality is something that I was never interested in.
Mm.
I didn't want to learn why do you need to use this color with that color and why do you need to make this line to make it go, you know, the shadow being darker or lighter. It didn't interest me, though I did it, everything, because you have to learn to get somewhere. But still I feel that it's still a long way. There is never an end to learning.
Yes.
And the struggle never ends.
True.
The
I guess
struggle
it's a
never.
Thing.
Yeah.
In anything that you do, not only. In
as long as it's not a struggle in your mind, it's you know, you'll get through it.
Yeah, because it's a way to release. It's yes. supposed to yeah. make you more comfortable with yourself and to grow in some yeah. way. So, Radhika the artist, where do you see yourself? Like you're saying, you're still a work in progress, I think you'd like to call yourself. So what is the aim? What is the goal? What do you want to keep doing? What are you saying to the world? I know there's so many questions I'm asking you, so feel free to yeah. pick whatever resonates with yeah. you. What are you telling the world through your art?
I think it's really important to make people see what you are seeing mm-hmm. and for them to not understand to know you. You are not somebody that they need to know. The art is somebody that they need to know.
Okay.
So I want to develop a connection, whoever is looking at the art, that why is she doing this? What is she trying to say? And the thought provoking the mind saying that the questions of why is what I want people to understand and have that question asked many times to themselves.
And what would be the answer? Why is Radhika doing this?
I guess it's very much very personal, right?
Yes.
Because it's something what you are thinking. It's not something what I'm thinking.
True.
You're just connecting with my art.
So I would see what I would see through your art is different maybe to what you were trying
Completely.
To express. And it just depends on the relationship I developed with your art.
That's true.
And you're a contemporary artist, so just talk to us a bit about it. But actually, I think later you'll be showing us a bit of your painting, so it will be easier to show. But just talking about contemporary art, what is it?
I guess it's a way of expressing yourself.
Through shapes, or is it like people, or is it a combination of things?
I think it's a combination. Because there's no specific word for saying contemporary, frankly. Mm-hmm. It's something that you are trying to say to the world, but what is the world trying to understand?
I love this. Say it again. I find you very inspirational, although yeah. you don't think so. And I think you have, we've talked off camera, that you don't like to talk about your achievements. But I really want to highlight those things, your achievements, to inspire other artists, because they might be thinking, okay, I can be an artist in the Middle East, in Oman, but what can I do with my passion? So if you can just talk about what you have done, what you are working on doing, because we also talked about the exhibition that you plan on doing on affordable yeah. art. So please talk a bit about your the art, Radhika the artist, as yeah. in her achievements.
Yeah, I guess, you know, I really got really interested in doing things to not only with the affordable art fair especially. It is something that Oman has a lot of fairs happening, there are a lot of things happening, there are a lot of exhibitions happening, but the artists sometimes don't have the guts to come out in public and showcase their work. Mm-hmm. Whereas when I started doing this affordable art fair, it was like anybody can participate. You're a teacher, you can still be a part of it. You're a professor, you can still be a part of it. So when I did this exhibition last year, I had a group of teachers who are teachers in the Scientific College of Design.
Yes.
So which was brilliant for me because, you know, they are like teachers always teach.
Yes.
They never ever showcase what they actually paint.
So this was their time to shine.
Basically. Yeah. So it was really interesting for me because I had like more than 20 teachers Excellent. Who were participating in different stalls and they were showcasing what they do.
And different nationalities. So
completely everyone. Everyone was welcome to
whoever
be a part of it. Whoever was an artist.
Excellent.
So I think that's something I'm really excited to do every year in December. And this year, you know, I'm very, very lucky. We have like a waiting list.
Oh, that's amazing.
So I'm hoping this goes to another level and, you know, people are like really keen to do more of it. And yeah. then probably I can do something twice a year. And, you know, I think it's like my baby.
Okay.
It's like I need to grow it slowly, slowly, nurture
where
it.
Where you've started and where it
yes.
has. So I'm sure you're very yeah. proud of that. And another thing, you were talking about the painting that you did for the airport.
Yeah.
If you can just talk a bit about that.
So it was really interesting the way it all started. There was a company that got in touch with me from India. Basically, they were also a part of the quotation for the airport. Mm-hmm. So they got in touch with me that we would like you to be on board and, you know, you cannot be an artist there, but we want you to be doing the whole airport. Unluckily or luckily, they didn't get through. So the whole idea dropped off there,
okay.
and then the Society of Fine Arts got, you know, like the deal that, okay, they will be taking care of the arts in the whole space, which was fantastic.
Exactly.
And once the society comes in, all the Omanis are there, and it was brilliant. Because, you know, that's what the airport should be. It is about the local art.
Yes.
It's about the local culture. Everything has to be local. If you're there on the airport, when you land in Oman, you feel that you are in Oman.
Yes.
And that's, yeah, that feel is so important. So the Society of Fine Arts did a brilliant job. And I was really, really proud to be on that list or acceptance list by them, by the airport, that they are happy to take my art. Though my art is not very traditional, it's very different to what other people, you know, do here. Mm-hmm. There's more of like
hundreds. That's nice.
So I'm very lucky.
To be unique in that sense. And just one more project I want to talk about, which was the Oman National Museum, where you had an exhibition there.
Yeah, that is a really interesting way that the exhibition came through. I started doing weaving in India before, I think, 5 years.
Weaving?
Yes. Really? That's the exhibition what we had in the National Museum.
Okay.
So, of course, Oman has a lot of history about weaving, and, you know, it's like the way you started the weaving the baskets and then slowly went into making the carpets. So there was a kind of inspiration that in Oman you always felt that it was something that even in India, my dad was into, he was not a weaver, but he was into making yarn.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it was always cloth and relation with that thread. So I was always inspired by doing something to do with thread. And of course, the relation of Oman and India having this, you know, the weaving as a common project.
Yes.
Well, my work is not similar to India weavers, not similar to the Omani weavers, but completely colorful and very different. But I thought it would be interesting to try and do something. So I started doing this work with some of the artisans locally there and started making these small little pieces. Of course, I ended up making 8 very large pieces. And it was really interesting. And then because it was related to the museum in the sense of the local art and, you know, the carpets and the way the museum is, it was something that I went and approached the museum. And we worked on the project for 2 years.
2 years?
Yes. So it was really interesting because, you know, you're just like back and forth and you're like, what are you going to showcase and what kind of work and what kind of idea do you have in mind?
Mm.
And the exhibition was really put together really nicely. And there were so many local people who were just walking in to see the exhibition space.
So as an Omani now, you have put your thumbprint and you have helped the society through their art and expressing themselves. So thank you so much for being part of it. And thank you, Radhika, for opening your house and sharing your story.
Thank you very much.
You're most welcome.
Thank you.